Something better than nothing. Something better than nothing. Today is the healing of the paralytic man. Healing of the paralytic man. The Bible tells us that the Lord went to the temple, and by the gate of the sheep, there was five porches leading to a pool, and around this pool, they were around this pool, they were a lot of sick people. Why? These sick people were expecting an angel of the Lord to come. He comes once a year. Once a year, and moves the water. Once the angel moves the water, the first one to jump into the water will be completely healed, no matter what he has. Complete cure. This is symbol of what? A symbol of what? Baptism. It is a baptism. The water is the same water. But the angel who comes and sanctify the water and move the water, yeah, means what? The Holy Spirit, when the priest prays on the water of the font, yeah, the Holy Spirit descends upon the water. And to make a visible sign, he moves the water. So everyone knows that the Holy Spirit or God has come and sanctified this water. The water looks water. يعني it doesn't change its appearance, but there is power went into this water, made it not anymore a normal water. It is like a medicine. It is healing water. That's what happened in the baptism. The water in the font of the baptism looks like normal water, but when the Holy Spirit descends upon it, it makes it a new womb that we are born from. That is what we have, the new nature from it, as if we are born again from the font of the baptism. In the Old Testament was once a year, but now whoever wants to be baptized anytime, he can have baptism anytime. That is the difference between the symbol and the reality. Our Lord Jesus Christ it's possessed there. Our Lord Jesus Christ went to the temple and he found one man. He went to this pool, and the Bible tells us there were a lot of sick people around the pool. All of them are waiting for the angels to come and move the water to jump into the water. It's only one who will be cured. That's why it is a competition. And the Lord among all those people in the pool went to one man. Only one man. Yes. He has no hope in that. So hope in the world. Yes, that is the good news. That's what this man was waiting for. There was no other reason for him to stay there when he has no man. He is waiting now for God himself. That is why the Lord went into this pool and and even praying. This man is telling every one of us, don't be in despair. Don't give up. Don't lose hope. The Lord is listening to you. The Lord is there for you. If you wait for Him, if you hold on Him, if you keep calling Him, He will come. He will come. Because He knows, He sees, He loves you. Then the Lord said to him, rise, get up, carry your bed, carry your mat, and go. The mat, which was a symbol of what? This mat, a symbol of what?
Sins.
No?
Sins.
This mat, a symbol of what holds us down. What holds us down? All the obstacles that around us. Now, he is saying, carry this mat and go. Get over your obstacles. Get over your disabilities. Get over. What holds you down? Some people are saying this is like a piece of wood he was sitting on, as if he was crucified and out of the nails he had, but even to make him to carry his cross and go. And this man just carried his mat and went. And the Bible tells us that in another time, the Lord is in the temple and they found this man again. Can you tell me why this man is in the temple anymore? Why this man is in the temple anymore? To give thanks. He was healed there. It's the house of God. It's where he met. It's where God have sent him the grace, the power for healing. Why are you here in the church? Because God's loved you. Because God has been glorified in your life. You come to his house to say, thank you, Lord. You come to his house to say, I want to meet you again, Lord. This man came again. Probably he was looking for that man who healed him. Probably he wanted to know that man. He regretted that he didn't ask this man, who are you? And who sent you to me? He came back. He came back looking for that man, looking for that power which healed him. And the Lord met him again. Even the Jews, when they asked him, who healed you? He said, I don't know. I don't know. That's why I am here. I'm looking for him. When the Lord met him, he told him something very important. Sin no more, otherwise it would be what? Worse. Sin no more, otherwise it would be worse. The Lord is saying that to every one of us. I can heal you. I can cure you. But don't take it for granted that every time I heal you, you go and sin again. Please, if I heal you, sin no more. If I forgive you, sin no more. If I help you, sin no more. Be grateful. Be grateful for my forgiveness, for my healing, for my love. Don't take advantage of my love. It would be worse. It would be worse. Some scholars are saying this man, after he was healed, he, when St. Mary was departed and they put her in the coffin and they were taking her to the tomb, he wanted to attack the coffin of St. Mary, and he pushed it, and when he pushed it, his hands been cut off his body and hanged on the coffin of St. Mary. And he screamed and remembered what the Lord had told him. And then the apostles said to him, repent and come again. And they put his hands back to him and it came back. But for all of us, sin no more. Otherwise, it would be worse. Sin no more. I hope that we all learn this verse from the Lord and keep repeating it. Keep repeating it. Be grateful for the grace of God. Be thankful for the grace of God. Because there is no gift without increase, except the one you love and thank him, without being grateful. And the Lord was teaching, healing, and leaving for us treasures to live by. So it was Pope Shenouda III. Pope Shenouda III. I honestly keep looking at him and learn from his silence at the moment, more than I have learned the whole of my life from his teaching and from his love and writings. He is a remarkable saint among us all, that we didn't appreciate him when he was around. But probably we can realize how great he was after he became silent, as if his silence was stronger than all his words and teachings and love and service in the church. We made two posters. I wanted every one of you to have a look at that and tell me which one you make, take a poster and keep it in the church for the family. Okay. this one which was taken for His Holiness, not long ago, which expresses that he was getting weaker and weaker, are saying to him the same expression he used to say, "For you I am here, and for you I go there." And we wrote underneath it, "It is time to see your holiness. It is time to see in your holiness what we haven't seen before." And it is true that many people have seen in His Holiness much more than what they have seen when he was alive. Or when he was with us, he is still alive, of course. And we say to him, "And for your holiness, what you haven't seen in us, what you haven't known about us, he now knows, he now sees, he now can help us more." And then he said, "Remember us before the throne of glory. Would you like this one or next one, please? This one." That one? We all agree about this one? So we will make a poster and keep it in the church, and as well put it on the website.